India, the land where the sun was born, fabled to be even richer than Persia, had never been explored or conquered. From the beginning, we struggled to unify a land without a center. Kings who conspired against one another. A labyrinth of tribes urged on by zealots and philosophers to die by the thousands for their strange gods. We saw things we'd never dreamed and could hardly describe. We saw birds that could talk and men that couldn't. Craterus and the advanced party fought against men with hairy skins who were tiny and lived on the tops of trees.
They're animals.
Till Hephaestion convinced us these were animals who imitated men but wore their own skin. They called this tribe monkey.
It's monkey. Monkey.
But we saw little difference with the tribes who lived among them.
So much like ours.
Oh, man.
Hello, little man.
Do they speak?
No.
But they do sing and make noises from the roofs of the forest.
We saw men who walked naked in public and spent hours at a time staring and doing nothing. Some who lived 200 years. And then there was the rain. Never before had we seen water that fell from the gods for 60 days and nights.
Well done today.
Go on, get to the women and children are fed.
No better mechanics. What's your son going to say? Come on, man. The older you get, the stronger.
Hey, great king. Tell my horse, Hansen. I'll be with you at your side.
Everything rotted in this rain. Scores of men died miserably from the tiny serpents that were everywhere in this evil land.
What happened, lad?
It's to the neck.
Oh, no! This, no. Hold on. Just hold on. Be brave. Be brave.
Our quest for gold and glory evaporated as we realized there was none to be had. Tempers worsened. We massacred all Indians who resisted. And with the local water putrid, we drank the strong wine.